Hi everyone, I'm Brian with Obedia and PC Audio Labs. Today, I'm showing you how to set up the PreSonus Monitor Station V2. Now, we are going to be using today to set this up the Audio Box I2 by PreSonus, but you can use essentially any audio interface that you would like. Here's what you will need to set up the Monitor Station V2. You'll want, of course, your Monitor Station V2, some quarter-inch cables to run between your audio interface and also your speakers from the Monitor Station V2. You'll need your audio interface, and really any audio interface should work. You'll need your computer, of course. You'll need some test tones, and those test tones will give you a link to where you can get those. We'll also provide you with a PreSonus Studio One song file, which you can download with those test tones in it. You will also need an SPL meter, a sound pressure level meter. Most of us are probably not going to have an SPL meter, and that is okay. You don't need a dedicated SPL meter. We'll point you to where you can get some that you can use right on your phone, and using that app, you'll be able to measure SPL levels in your studio. This is useful for when you are calibrating your monitor setup with the Monitor Station V2. As long as you've got all those things, let's dive in and talk about how you can set up the Monitor Station V2. The first thing I'm going to mention is that you should essentially, when starting to set up the Monitor Station V2, zero out the board entirely. Just turn all of the knobs all the way counterclockwise, and the reason for this is that you're going to be doing a lot of things here that initially could potentially cause a lot of noise because you're using test tones. You don't want to blow yourself out of the water. You don't want to do damage to any speakers or, of course, your hearing. So just zero out the board because you're actually not going to need to hear a lot of what's coming out of the Monitor Station V2 until you start to get into calibrating your speakers. The first thing that you want to do is connect your audio interface to the Monitor Station V2. And I just have a set of quarter-inch cables right here, left and right. And I'm going to take these and I'm going to plug them into the first input on the back of the Monitor Station V2. There's a Stereo 1 and a Stereo 2 input on the Monitor Station, as you can see from the main source selector buttons right here. I'm just going to connect my quarter-inch cables, as I say, to Stereo 1. That's going to be my primary focus, but you can run other sources into the Monitor Station as well. So now I have run my audio interface out and into my Monitor Station V2. Next, you may want to set and calibrate the Monitor Station V2's LED meter. By default, the Monitor Station V2's LED meter is going to be calibrated so that the red 0 VU meter right here in the middle of the unit illuminates when the selected source signals reach plus 10 decibels unloaded. So this might work for you, and you might want to change this. There are two other options, which is plus 4 and plus 18 decibels unloaded. And if you want to learn more about what that means, we'll link some articles for you. You can also give us a call at Obedia, and we can talk about that as well. What this basically comes down to is if you want accurate metering, you want to select different metering modes on the Monitor Station V2. As I said, by default, when the selected source, in this case, let's say main source Stereo 1, reaches plus 10 decibels unloaded, that means that you're going to illuminate the red meters on the center VU meter right here. Like I say, that may work for some of you and you may want to change that. If you want to change that, you can swap that to plus 4. And in order to do that, you'll want to press and hold the Q source Stereo 1 button, which is this one right here, while powering on the Monitor Station V2. If you want it to be at plus 10 decibels unloaded, you're going to want to hold down Q source Stereo 2 while powering on the Monitor Station V2. And finally, if you would like to set this to plus 18 decibels unloaded, then you'll want to press and hold the Q aux source button while powering on the Monitor Station V2. This will allow you to swap back and forth between different LED VU meter calibrations on the Monitor Station V2. Next, we want to set the audio output level of your audio sources. Your sources are going to sound their best through the Monitor Station V2 when their outputs are set correctly, of course. Now, to optimally set the output level of an audio source, that source should be able to produce a 1 kHz sine wave test tone, either by playing it back or generating it from a generating source. Now, as I said earlier in this video, we will give you some test tones that you can download and a Studio One song file that you can load up as well with those test tones in it. Those test tones, while being played back, are going to allow you to set the output level of your audio source. And these steps are very easy. As I said earlier, the first step, zero out your board entirely. Leave it completely zeroed out. Next, you're going to want to turn down the audio outputs of your primary audio source connected to the Monitor Station V2. So, on the audio box I2, that would mean that I'm going to turn down the main output knob all the way. And that is already turned down on my audio box I2. Next, you'll want to select the source button that you're going to be using for the source coming into the monitor station. And I, of course, I'm going to use main source stereo 1 as my primary source. I'll also want to make sure that no other source buttons are currently lit up while I am doing this setting. Now, with our 1 kHz test tone loaded in Studio One or in our audio player or using a sound generator, with that loaded and playing back, we're going to turn up the primary audio output on our audio source until we start to see the red VU meters happening on the Monitor Station V2. So you can see I've got that right there. And there's my setting on the audio box I2. And of course, you may wish to recalibrate the meters on your Monitor Station V2 using the steps that I previously explained in this video. Now let's calibrate our speaker levels. Speaker calibration is very useful because this sets the output level of your speakers so that a specific level shown on the Monitor Station V2's meter equals a specific acoustic level in your studio as measured in decibels SPL, sound pressure level. Now, as I was talking about, you would want to have a sound pressure level meter for doing this, but you can get one of these for your phone as well, and generally they are free. And a quick note before we dive into speaker calibration, this is not necessarily the perfect way to do this. There are many, many ways to calibrate your studio and the speakers in your studio. This is just one way to do this and to do this with the Monitor Station V2. You may want to use different methods depending on your studio setup, the type of space that you're in, how acoustically treated it is. All of these things are going to factor in when it comes to dialing in your audio. For this step, you're going to want some pink noise. And again, we'll provide you with some pink noise and a pink noise test tone that you can use. You want a pink noise test tone that you can use at around 500 hertz to 2.5 kilohertz. You want bandwidth limited pink noise at a level of negative 20 decibels. When you're calibrating a subwoofer, you're going to want to use some different pink noise levels, but we're not going to talk about calibrating subwoofers today. And as I say, you can get these test tones in the description of this video. You can find these at obedia.com. You'll also want an SPL meter. And as I was talking about, you can get SPL meters. You could get a dedicated SPL meter if you want and use that dedicated SPL meter. But what I have right here is just simply an SPL application on my Android phone. You should be able to find these for iPhones as well. This was free, and you can use this in order to measure SPL in your studio. Step one of this process, I'm going to be making use of one of my studio monitors that I have right here. And the first thing I'm going to do is zero out the input knob on my speaker. I've zeroed this out completely. I've also completely zeroed out the Monitor Station V2, as I was talking about earlier in this video. Next, I'm going to place my SPL metering device. And essentially, I want to place my SPL monitoring device at about the apex of where my studio monitors are pointing when I'm going to be sitting, listening, mixing, and etc. And you can mount your SPL on a boom mic stand, perhaps. You can have a friend hold it while you make some adjustments, many different ways to do this. But place that SPL meter, and now you're going to get ready to send some test tones out of this speaker and to that SPL meter. Next, on the Monitor Station V2, I'm going to select the source and sending audio into the Monitor Station V2 with. I'm using main source stereo 1. I will also select speaker A, which is the first set of speakers I will be using with the Monitor Station, and the speakers that I'm going to be plugging into the Monitor Station V2. Now I'm going to plug my speakers into the speaker A output on the back of my Monitor Station V2. And I'm also going to adjust the speaker output trim knob on the back of the Monitor Station V2. I'm going to turn this down all the way. Every output on the Monitor Station V2 is currently zeroed. Now in Studio One, I'm going to pan the pink noise output channel all the way to the left because I'm going to calibrate speaker by speaker. So I'm starting with only the left speaker. And after I have panned the output in Studio One or on my playback source all the way to the left, I'm going to start the playback of my pink noise. Now, with my pink noise playing back, I want to make certain that it's not going through any signal processing, no reverbs, compressors, anything like that. Keep it as clean as possible, and that's a good reason to use the download that we're going to give you, because it's going to be a straight, clean signal that you can use for your test purposes. Now, we shouldn't hear anything here because we turned everything down in step one. If you do hear anything, you want to go back, you want to make sure you zero everything out at this point. Now, don't be scared, but this is where we're going to start to do our calibration. We're going to turn our main output gain knob on the Monitor Station V2 up all the way, fully counterclockwise. Now, on the back of the Monitor Station, we're going to turn up that speaker A trim knob all the way, fully counterclockwise. This is going to differ based on your own acoustic space and your own setup, and I'll show you just a quick shot of me doing some of this in the studio here and just a jump over here. But now what you're going to do is you're going to slowly turn up the input knob on your monitor. On your SPL meter, you start to show a level of about 80 decibels SPL or whichever target level you have chosen. So all you'll be doing is bringing up the input level on your monitor and the monitor specifically that you are calibrating, and you're going to hear that pink noise. And remember, this is going to make a lot of noise, so make sure you do this when hopefully you're not going to drive anyone too crazy, because you're going to need to turn this up fairly loud in order to reach 80 decibels SPL. And I'll just show you a little bit what this sounds like. You can see it's pretty noisy. And again, you want to make sure you do this when you're not hopefully going to drive anyone completely crazy. But after you have done this for your left speaker, you'll repeat the same process for your right speaker. And then you should have properly calibrated your speakers as well as your Monitor Station V2. This should give you the best mixing experience that you can possibly get while you are using the Monitor Station V2. And that, my friends, is how easy it is to set up the PreSonus Monitor Station V2 in your home studio. And remember, there are a couple things here that are not necessarily set in stone. Specifically, you want to set your SPL setting in your studio to something that, again, is going to hit around the mark of 80 decibels SPL, but make sure that you're doing this with your mix settings in mind. You want to remember where you're going to be sitting. You want to think about how it is that you are going to be mixing, because you want a comfortable mixing experience when you are using the Monitor Station V2. And if you use these tips that I've outlined for you here, I think that you're going to get that. Now, if you do have questions, comments, if there's anything that we can help you with here at Obedia, make sure to give us a call. We are here 7 days a week to help you tame your technology, get the most out of your digital audio hardware and software, because that's what we do best here at Obedia. If you guys want to find the Monitor Station V2, you can visit pcaudiolabs.com, where you can purchase the Monitor Station. And of course, make sure to check out the PreSonus website at PreSonus.com to get all the information about the full line of PreSonus audio hardware, interfaces, software, and everything that PreSonus offers for you, the digital musician. As always, guys, I'm Brian with Obedia and PC Audio Labs, and I want to thank you for tuning in today. Until next time, happy music making to you, and take care. Today's pro audio hardware and software can give you excellent results if you know how to use it properly. Obedia can help you to get the most out of your pro audio hardware and software. Why spend your time scouring the internet for answers or digging through manuals? With one quick call to an Obedia technician, you'll be connected with someone who can give you the answers that you need in real time via phone and remote desktop. Obedia technicians are trained in all major digital audio applications on Mac, PC, iOS, and Android devices. Obedia member subscriptions are cost-effective, give you great member benefits, and Obedia is here 7 days a week to help you get the most out of your digital audio hardware and software. No matter what your level of expertise, Obedia can help you to stay focused and productive and get your music back on track. Start taming your technology today with Obedia.